I'm busy tending to my crops and bees. Ain't got no time for small talk. If you need something, spit it out quick so I can get back to work. Of course, I've heard of war. This ain't my first day in Calradia. You know, wars come and go like the changing of seasons. Right now, the Western Empire is fighting the looters, and the Sea Raiders are at odds with the Union. Batania squaring up against Aserai, and Tuzate's clashing with Karakajit. And let's not forget about Sturge's ongoing battle with those pesky looters. But enough of that chatter, I gotta get back to my farming duties. What recent battle are you talking about, stranger? Battles happen all the time in this land, and they all blend together after a while. If you're looking for details on a specific fight, you'll need to be more specific. Well, that's a shame for the folks in Jalmaris, but it ain't none of my business. As long as my village is safe and sound, I don't much care who wins or loses these battles. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got work to do. I'm a farmer and a beekeeper. If you must know, my crops and my bees keep me busy enough without having to worry about the wars and politics happening around us. If you need honey or some fresh vegetables, you can come to me, but if you're here to waste my time with idle chatter, then kindly leave me be. I don't take care of animals, stranger. I'm a beekeeper, as I've already told you. I tend to my hives, harvest their honey, and sell it at the market. It's honest work that keeps me fed and clothed. Now, if you're interested in learning more about bees or honey production, feel free to ask. Otherwise, I suggest you go bother someone else. Dialogue analysis. The stranger tries to engage Thunder in conversation about war, but Thunder is dismissive and uninterested. No, I don't make liquor for my honey, and even if I did, it wouldn't be for the likes of you. You come here asking about battles and then switch to asking about alcohol. You're wasting my time, and frankly, you're starting to annoy me. If you want to buy some of my produce, that's fine. But if you're just here to chat and drink, then kindly leave me be. You're my ruler, you say. Helborn is the one who owns this village, and if he appointed you to rule over me, then so be it. But that doesn't mean you can come up to me and waste my precious farming and beekeeping hours with your idle chatter. If you have any business with me, state it clearly and be on your way. Otherwise, don't bother coming back. If you truly are who you claim to be, my lord, then forgive my rudeness. It's not every day that someone of your stature comes to speak with a humble farmer like myself. What can this lowly villager do for you? Yes. Well, when one spends their days toiling in the fields and tending to bees, one doesn't have time for idle chats. And when a stranger approaches me with no clear purpose other than to waste my time, it tends to put me in a foul mood. So pardon me if my manners are lacking, but I have work to do. As I said before, I don't make liquor for my honey, and furthermore, my produce is not for sale to anyone who comes along asking for it. If you want to buy some, go to the market like everyone else. Now please, leave me be so that I can get back to my farming and beekeeping duties. My apologies, my lord. I didn't realize it was you, but just because you are my lord doesn't mean that I will tolerate disrespect or rudeness towards me, and forgive me for saying so, but your behavior towards me thus far has been less than courteous. However, since you are my ruler, I will offer you a small sample of my finest honey for your troubles. It's not much, but it's the best I can do at the moment. I appreciate your suggestion, stranger, but I have no interest in making liquor from my precious and hard-earned honey. It would take away from the purity and natural sweetness of the product that I work so hard to produce. And frankly, I don't need your money. I make a decent living selling my goods at the market without resorting to making alcohol. So please, take your business elsewhere and let me get back to my work. Yes, I know how to make it, but that doesn't mean I'm going to make it for you or anyone else. Making good quality honey and maintaining healthy bee colonies is a time-consuming and delicate process, and adding additional steps to the production process could compromise the quality of the final product. Plus, even if I did decide to make some, it would be for personal consumption only. Honey is too valuable a commodity to simply give away or sell cheaply. I'm sorry, stranger, but as I said before, I have no interest in making or sharing my recipe for honey liquor. It's a closely guarded secret that has been passed down through my family for generations, and it's not something that I'm willing to share with just anybody who asks. If you're truly interested in making your own, there are plenty of recipes available online or at the market. best for me. I'll be sticking to my tried and true method of producing high quality honey. Now if you'll excuse me, I have work to do. No, you fool. As I said before, I don't make any kind of alcohol from my precious and hard-earned honey. And even if I did, why would I tell you? Besides, accusing me of secretly doing something that goes against my principles and values is insulting and disrespectful. If you have no business to discuss with me, then please leave me be. Just because I know the recipe for making honey liquor doesn't mean that I make it. It's a part of my family's traditional knowledge and something that has been passed down through generations. And as a beekeeper, it's important to have a deep understanding of the many uses and applications of my product. But once again, let me be clear. I have no interest in making or selling liquor from my honey. And if that's all you're interested in, then kindly take your business elsewhere. Well, stranger, you're entitled to your own opinion, but the fact remains that I don't make or sell any kind of alcohol from my precious and hard-earned honey. If you still don't believe me, then that's your problem, not mine. As a beekeeper, my main priority is to produce high-quality and pure honey for the market, and if you're not interested in buying any of it, then please leave me be so that I can get back to my work. As a skilled and experienced beekeeper, I make a wide variety of products from my delicious and natural honey. Some of the most popular items that I offer at the marketplace include beeswax candles, propolis tinctures, royal jelly supplements, and even handmade soap bars infused with the sweet aroma of fresh beeswax. And of course, my signature product is my award-winning, all-natural raw honey that has been carefully harvested and prepared to preserve its rich flavor and nutritional benefits. If you're looking for quality, purity, and craftsmanship in your choice of homegrown products, then you won't find a better choice than my line of artisanal goods. But if all you're looking for is a recipe for making liquor, then I'm afraid I can't help you with that. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have some important tasks to attend to. Well, stranger, while I can't make any specific medical claims about the curative properties of my honey, I can tell you that it is a natural and healthy source of energy, antioxidants, and other vital nutrients. It's been used for centuries as a natural remedy for sore throats, coughs, and other respiratory ailments. But if you have a serious illness or condition that requires medical attention, I highly recommend that you seek the advice of a qualified physician or healthcare professional. My apologies, my lord. I didn't mean to offend you. It's just that I'm not accustomed to speaking with someone of your stature so informally. How may I be of service to you? I'm sorry, stranger, but I'm not a physician and I don't personally know any in the area. However, there may be some skilled healers or herbalists in nearby towns who could assist you. You may want to check with the local notables or visit the marketplace to see if anyone is offering such services. But again, if you have a serious health concern, it's always best to seek professional medical attention from a qualified physician or healthcare provider. Thank you, my lord. Your words are kind and encouraging. I will continue to work hard and produce the highest quality honey that I possibly can. May the gods bless our land with abundance and prosperity.